All right. Hi, everybody. I'm so excited today to be here with my friend and colleague, Josh Crafford. Josh is somebody who I knew when he worked at the same company, but with it had a different name. It was GE Capital, and now he's at Synchrony. And we've collaborated together on one of the first book clubs for the introvert, creating introvert-friendly workplaces. And we've just come off the tail end of finishing it today. And both of us were so excited about how it went that we wanted to share that with others and kind of share some lessons learned. So Josh, welcome.
Thank you, Jennifer. Thank you for inviting me and excited to be here. The book club was highly successful, so I'm happy to talk about it with you.
Well, it really was a pleasure, as we say, to work with you. Could you tell everybody, what is your role now? I know you've moved around the company, and what is your role at Synchrony? And what is, yeah. For people so who I'm don't the, know, what is Synchrony?
Okay. Synchrony is a financial company that's also a technology company. So we do financing for several businesses. We have retail businesses, we have private label businesses, we have Care Credit, and we do both consumer and business loans. Very high level what we do.
It's quite impressive. And I know that you, a couple things about you, your CEO just won a top award as one of the top women in business. And also, you have committed, and she and I think the leadership team has committed to a fully remote virtual return to work, right? To continue. You want to say a word about that?
Yes.
Yeah.
First of all, Margaret Keane, our CEO, is absolutely phenomenal. She has been a driver of culture for us, which has been absolutely remarkable. So when we were GE Capital, right, we were under their umbrella. It was their corporate culture. Margaret came over as our CEO and brought her chief staff with her, which has been just absolutely committed to making sure that every employee can bring their whole selves to work. We have different diversity networks to make sure that everybody is comfortable being who they are. And I love this book club that we're doing now because this hits on another form of diversity, which is introversion, to make sure that everybody's comfortable there. And yes, we have been 100% remote since about March, mid-March. And then the company has made the commitment to get rid of a lot of our physical office spaces so that we can remain at home and be safe. But this is also a new way to work that we're learning how to collaborate differently. We're learning how to work differently, but we've also been able to adopt a much more agile way of working, which is much more efficient. And one thing that they even did just recently was to say, okay, no more hour-long meetings. We're going to do 25 and 45-minute meetings just to respect people, how busy they are, but to give us that extra 5 to 15 minutes back to get up, stretch our legs, go check on our kids that are doing homework.
I love it.
So, yeah, they've been very mindful. It's been fantastic.
And we heard some people in the book club today say that was, they believe that was very introvert friendly. So very cool. So really it kind of fits in the book club and rolling that out as a virtual offering. Kind of really fits into that format, right? But talk a little bit about why you decided to select this book for the book club, and also actually have a book club, because I know you're going to continue this with other books.
Yeah, so this was the idea to have a book club is based off of Great Places to Work. So we participate in Great Places to Work. We've had the honor of being in the top 100, and I believe we've been in the top 50. Yeah. Great Places to Work companies for the last 4 years since we kind of broke off from GE Capital to Synchrony. And we're always looking at new ways to develop managers and leaders of people. And we were trying to think, what is something that we can do that doesn't feel as much as like traditional learning? And I'm sorry, I don't think I answered it before, but my current role is VP of Learning and Development for the technology organization. prior to that, I was VP of Learning Development for marketing. And prior to that, I was VP of Learning Development for corporate, helping to transition from GE to Synchrony. So it's been a great journey in the learning and development field. And this book club is a really nice addition, especially now that we're virtual, because we had people from our India site participating in this book club right alongside people from all throughout the U.S. And we all were on an even playing field virtually. So all of our voices were heard the same. All of our pictures showed up the same. So it was really nice to be able to sit shoulder to shoulder, if you would, with people from all around the country and all around the world.
I'm sorry, John. Yeah. I was just going to say kudos to those Indian folks, because they were doing this oftentimes late at night. I know we had one planning call with Aditha on our team at 4 a.m. So, you know, we have no idea what not getting sleep is, right? But the global aspect was great. So you said that this was really an outgrowth, the actual tangible launch of the book club was an outgrowth of the of this feedback that you got. You came up very high in the rankings, but there was an opportunity that you identified to me from the best places to work, or is it great places to work? I can't remember.
Great places to work.
Okay. Yep. And a shout out to my friend Ed Freuenhammer, who was involved in the writing of that book. That you said that there was some outgrowth of that, of a need that people had that they expressed. And then you thought the book club would be a good way to address that.
Yeah, we thought it'd be a fun way to get people to interact differently together. One of the things that we were even talking about from the book club today is not being able to network as much with people outside of your immediate teams. You know, we used to all get together at big conventions for different networking events, but we've lost that ability to do so. And one of the terms that someone used that I had highlighted in my notes was accidental interactions, where you get to meet different people. And that just struck me. And doing this book club, we were hoping, because it was people all throughout the technology organization. And, you know, there are some silos and some different verticals within the technology organization where people might not get to meet each other. But this is, once again, a really nice way to even the playing field, to have everybody participate as equals, regardless if you're, you know, an assistant vice president or you're a senior executive within the company as well.
And we did
so
have
all voices were heard. Equally.
All voices. Exactly.
Yes, we did.
That was very impressive. I know we weren't sure, but there were several senior leaders who showed up consistently, right? And you randomized the groups, you had breakouts. So let's talk a little bit about execution for those people who might be interested in what you did, how you did it. How did you structure the book club and what worked about that?
Yeah, so we tried to determine how long we want the session to run. So it was an hour every Friday morning, and Friday mornings intentionally because it's lower meetings. So it was a good spot where it was available on the majority of people's calendars. And then for your book specifically, we did it where we covered 2 chapters per week, which was a good amount. We were considering, do we do 1 chapter per week, but then it goes 8 weeks, but a total of four sessions. In addition to your fireside chat, was a phenomenal way of kicking it off, which we can get into in a minute, I'm sure. Worked out really well. And then we just kept it really simple to what we wanted the topics to be that we were covering each week, which was what was one aha moment or a couple. What was your favorite section or favorite part of those 2 chapters? And then really importantly, to make sure that it wasn't just a fun book club and networking, but we actually intentionally can bring this back to help change our culture and help influence our work, was what would you do differently at work based off of these 2 chapters? And just keeping it really simple to those 3 questions kept the conversations flowing and going pretty deep.
That's terrific. We're going to love to hear a few examples, or maybe I can ask you that now about what people said they were doing differently. Mm-hmm. I'll start it off just by hearing an extrovert today who was very impressed by the fact that he really realized and accepted he didn't know very much. And so he decided that he started to pause more. And he was aware of doing this in between the sessions and still found it challenging, but is finding that people are opening up because of that more. Were there other specific takeaways that you could remember that yourself or others
Absolutely.
Shared?
Well, something that I even started doing differently, and we had always told people and encouraged people to put agenda items into a meeting. And especially if you were going to call on someone during a meeting or if you needed any information from them during a meeting. And sometimes we did, sometimes we didn't. But now much more intentionally, really pushing people that if they don't have an agenda in a calendar invite that they're sending out, to push back and say, hey, can you let us know the details? Can you let us prepare better? If there's any pre-work that can be done. And honestly, in learning and development, we stopped sending people pre-work because about half the group would do it and half the group wouldn't. And then when it came time in class to say, okay, everybody, pull out your pre-work. And then we'd have to take 15 or 20 minutes for those that hadn't done it to do it. Mm-hmm. But all the introverts were saying, no, we really like that. And someone used the term, it's threading the needle, so that, you know, if during those 15 to 20 minutes where the people that didn't do the pre-work are now doing it, then the introverts might be able to go back and reflect on what we'd already been talking about in class or reflect deeper about the activity that we're going to do and help them prepare to be ready to be more engaged and talk a little bit more during that. So it actually builds in a nice break and gives the people the time to think and soak in the information ahead of time.
And so you were catering to
just
extroverts.
Those are a couple of things.
Yeah, that was excellent. You were catering to extroverts as well, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Well, one tip that I heard, I just happened to sit in on the session this morning, and somebody talked about, the group was trying to figure out how to replicate those social interactions that you used to have offsite, and you know, where you go to a bar and do things where, you know, there would be games.
Yeah.
And then one of the folks came up with the idea to do video games and do this. No problem for us. They're IT people, so they know how to do it.
Right. Right.
So, you know, they were getting creative together and sort of brainstorming together. And these were folks that didn't, as you say, work together necessarily. It seemed like there was a lot of openness to sharing.
Yeah. One other interesting call out that you had actually corrected me on, and you're 100% right. So I'm glad we didn't bet. I thought it would be hard because we were doing these for an hour long. And so we had a structure where the first 10 minutes, we're going to talk about what it is that we're going to talk about. Mm-hmm. So the setup for the hour, the first 10 minutes, everybody kind of logs on. We do a little bit of, hey, how are you doing? But it was also break us up into the teams. And we tried to be mindful of having different level people in different verticals throughout technology be on different teams so that people would get a chance to meet new people. So you get to see who your team was. You get to see what the three questions, you know, your aha moment, favorite section, and then what would you do differently to help prepare. And then we break into teams for 40 minutes, and then we'd call everybody back together for the last so that the two different groups could share some of the things that had come up. I honestly didn't think that we'd be able to get people to talk for 40 minutes. And you said, oh no, once you get a group of introverts together and comfortable, you can't get them to stop talking. And you were 100% right. It was fantastic. I think this was some of the best engagement that I've had from some of the people that I knew that were in these groups. So
and
it was great.
And what would you say, Z? Well, thank you for that. And I mean, what would you say is the lesson there that you might want to pass on to people around what makes people open up?
Well, it was the intentionality. We also laid ground rules where we had told people, you know, only one person speaking at a time. And we're going to try to make sure that everybody gets a chance to speak. If you don't want to speak, that's okay. We also had sent out in advance to say, you know, here's the two chapters that we're covering this week, as well as here's the three questions that we're going to ask. And we could kind of feed off of each other. And I think it was a couple people were okay talking at first. And then as the other people got comfortable to say, okay, this is a safe environment. I can open up and I can bring some of my personal experiences into this, that they got comfortable talking about it.
Gotcha.
And we also assigned roles. So we said, okay, there's going to be a leader in each group that kind of helps keep the conversation going. There's going to be a timekeeper so that, you know, we can kind of get to talk about both chapters and the aha moments, as well as what you're going to do differently at work. And then there was a scribe. So it was, you know, someone to take notes, just little bullets, so that when we do pull the two groups back together, you can share what were some of the highlighted moments from your group. And it worked out really well.
It got everybody involved with different roles that they played too. And one thing that I really love that you did, Josh, and I know because you've been a leader and you are a leader, is that you actually gave a little push to the team members who volunteer to do this. And some of them had never used the platform, one of the person in charge of that, and he had to go out and get help from somebody else on the team. And another person was not comfortable necessarily doing a facilitation. So she kind of worked with the extrovert on that. There were just a lot of really nice moments where I saw that you had delegated, you know, the responsibility so that that team felt very engaged and involved and were invested in the book club. Do you want to say anything else about that, about your experience doing that or any lessons learned?
It was nice growth opportunities that we were trying to provide other people. So one thing, it's hard to step up sometimes as a volunteer. And in doing so, if you are going to help run something, and it would have been really hard if I tried to run the whole thing myself. So I was glad that we had some people that volunteered that said, yes, I would like to have some growth experiences. But it was also to say, what are you comfortable with? And with the person that was more introverted, to say, well, we kind of want you to kick off the meeting. We want you to help facilitate, to say what it was that we're doing. Where she was a little bit more uncomfortable, that's where we did say, okay, why don't we have co-facilitators to do that part?
Right.
So it was being able to listen to people and understand where they wanted to grow and how they wanted to be involved and try to work towards that as a win-win situation.
I love seeing this. And so another lesson for people is doing a book club. It's it's a great opportunity for growth for people. But, and the B that I think was implicit here is that we had a senior leadership involved, so they got to see some other people step up, and it was a very nice visibility opportunity. Would you agree with that?
100%. Yeah, and one of the goals of one of the person, and he's newer to the company, was I want to get some more exposure. And this was a really good way cross-functionally to get exposure across the entire technology organization.
Yeah, so it's a great coaching approach that you can use. And I saw you in the role of executive sponsor, and I would think that that's something you might want to suggest or you would replicate again with somebody else or for yourself to continue somebody to play that role going forward. Would you agree? Or what, any thoughts on that?
Yes, 100%. Well, it's always nice. And I think they knew that with someone being there, if they got stuck or if things didn't go well, that someone had their back. That could kind of step in, but not overstep. So try to be respectful of them and their space. And honestly, even when we tried new technology breaking out into the breakout rooms today, it's like, you know, and where this was the fourth session, everybody didn't care because we were all very comfortable with each other by this point. And I think we had bonded in a really nice way. Honestly, since we've been virtual, this was the best bonding experience that I've had with a group of people.
Wow.
In a virtual setting. Yeah.
Well, those companies who are listening to this, we'll make Josh, are you willing to be a resource? I'd be happy to point people to you because I think one of the things that I tried to emphasize in the book is that we are looking for pockets of introvert inclusion. And the best practices, like the one that you actually took the plunge and did the book club. It wasn't just a piece of paper in the book, which it had started out as. And you made it happen. Yeah. You brought it to life. So before we kind of close out, I would love to also have you share, at this point, we're going to do a survey, I believe, on what people thought, a very quick survey. But in terms of your anecdotal observations, is there anything that you would, if you were suggesting to somebody that you learned or that you might do differently next time that you think could be tightened up here with the four sessions?
Honestly, where we didn't know how it would go, mm-hmm. we did market it a little bit and we did put out that we were doing this, but since it was the first time, we didn't know if it would be as successful as it was. Mm-hmm. We didn't put a ton of marketing out there because we didn't want, too we were more people. Comfortable with 30 people
right,
than 200 people.
Yeah.
Yeah. So next time, I'm more than comfortable to put out more marketing around it. And one of the things that we, even after the first session where we felt that it was going successfully, we asked people to reach out to other leaders throughout the technology organization that hadn't joined yet to say, hey, there's still time, still come in. Mm-hmm. Even if you haven't read the first couple chapters, we'd love to have you as part of the conversation because everybody's had personal experiences that you refer to in the book that we can all relate to. So there were a couple times where people were like, sorry guys, it was a crazy week. I didn't get to read the chapters. But based off of what you're talking about and really starting off with the aha moments and what was your favorite section, people understood exactly what they were talking about or what you were referring to in the book. So it was really easy for people that hadn't read it yet to join into those conversations.
Yeah.
So I would just encourage that more going into it next time to say, even if you didn't get a chance to read these chapters, I think people didn't join because they're like, oh, I didn't read the chapters. I can't join.
Okay.
No, encourage everybody to join just to be part of the conversation.
Right. They have something to contribute is what you're saying. Yeah.
Absolutely. Or even if they're just hearing the conversation of other people, they're going to learn a lot.
Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. So, well, this has been fantastic. I really want to give a shout out to Synchrony for really doing what we've been talking about. You mentioned it a few times, changing a culture. And we've encouraged the people in the group to go out there and share this with other functions, other divisions, because mm-hmm. it is a learning process, understanding about yourself and your own strengths and preferences, as well as your biases, and how that plays out in your role as a contributor at Synchrony. So any other things you want to say before we end the recording? And thank you so much for this, by the way.
Oh, of course. My pleasure. It's always great to work with you, Jennifer.
I didn't pay
the
you.
The one thing that... No, not at all.
No, not today.
The one thing that we briefly touched on that I do want to circle back on, which I know meant a lot to the people that were in the book club, was that you kicked it off with a fireside chat. Mm-hmm. And they got to know you, the author, because there are some, even in doing learning development, there are some hypotheticals where people might debate back and forth. But having you there to kick it off, to answer questions, especially the biggest aha that we had during the fireside chat is we ran a survey of people to say whether you think you're an introvert, an extrovert, an ambivert. And after you gave the definition of it's where you get energy from and you were able to have conversations with different people, they were like, oh, I am an introvert. Mm-hmm. And it's okay to be that. You know, there's nothing wrong with it. I think 50% of the population is introverted. They just might not be heard as much because the extroverts talk so much. So I think a lot of people had a really nice self-realization, especially in this book and especially in this topic, to say, I am an introvert and it's okay. And here's ways that I can help other introverts throughout my company. So that was a phenomenal, I think, personal gain for a lot of people.
I'm glad that you found that and your group found that to be helpful. And that's the model we've constructed based on years of doing this like we did with your company years ago, starting out with the baseline education. And then the book club allows us to go deeper, allows people to really explore and feel, as you say, build trust, come away with skills and strengths that they can use each week And also, as you mentioned, connect with each other, develop some new networking relationships mm-hmm. that will help them in their careers and in their performance. So Josh, I can't thank you enough for taking time today to share your experience. And if anybody wants to get in touch with Josh, he's on LinkedIn, Josh Crafford, C-R-A-F-F-O-R-D. Josh is also, I should say, an author who is writing some terrific books. If you want to kind of throw that in now as to what you're working on, or should we keep it a secret right now? Why don't we do that?
Keep it a secret for now. It's still in draft form, being worked on, being edited.
But we will reveal that within the next few months. It's very, very exciting. So thank you, Josh. Thank you, everybody, for listening. And let us
know,
contact me or to learn more about the book club. And we'll go from there. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you. Take care.
Thank you.